Hi everyone, my name is Dr. Tanya Batra and today we'll be talking about a very interesting topic which often comes up as a short note in your university examination and sometimes if it has come as a multiple choice question in your NEET PG exam and in the government residentship exam and fellowship exam. So the topic is Munchausen syndrome by proxy. I'm sure few of you might have heard about it and it's a very interesting disease. Because here the child is not ill, the parents or the caregivers, they have fabricated the illness. So they come to the hospital or a clinic and they will project as the child is having some kind of illness or some kind of problem. But when you examine the child will be absolutely healthy. So it's a kind of mental disorder and it's a kind of problem which is with the parent or the caregiver. So it is a form of child abuse definitely to a child because the parents will beat the child up or sometimes they produce fake symptoms like they'll mix the blood with the urine and they themselves give them medication so the child has diarrhea or vomiting and sometimes they beat the child up and sometimes they say a lie that the child is having toothache. So the child will come to a dental clinic, you will examine him and he will not have any symptom, any other problem. So the doctor really gets confused at that time and if you see the medical records or the dental records of that patient, the patient will definitely have variety of tests, investigations and even treatments in different setups. Their parents will not prefer going up to the same hospital, they'll turn up to different hospitals and different clinics. Sometimes the caregiver or the parents do this to claim the medical insurance, sometimes they do it because they are over possessive for the child. So it's an interesting form of child abuse which is prevalent especially in the urban population because then the parents are definitely they're more protective towards the child. So how do we diagnose this problem? Definitely this kind of problem which is also called as a falsification disease and it was actually given, the first concept was given by John Meadows way back in 1977. So this concept, if we have to diagnose it, we definitely have to see the deep-rooted psychology behind it and the parents also require certain kind of psychological counseling definitely. And if we see the child, definitely the child doesn't have any particular symptoms as such, the child will be absolutely healthy and he won't talk to you like much and the parents will keep on complaining that the child has this problem, the child has that problem. So you should all know about this disease because it is a very common form of multiple choice question which might turn up in your examination. So I hope you understood it and thank you.